Good morning, students. Welcome back. I am Rajni Bhatt, PGD Social Science from GPS Haldwani, Lamachaur. Students, again we are here with our previous chapter of Economics, Globalization and the Indian Economy. Students, in our previous session, we came to know about the meaning of globalization. Then we came to know about the different factors which are essential for the process of globalization. And then at last, we came to know about the meaning of MNCs and then their significant role for the process of globalization. Now, the different subtopics which we are going to cover today in today's session are barriers on foreign trade. Okay, students, in this first subtopic, we will discuss about different barriers for the process of foreign trade. What are these barriers? Okay, and why do we need these barriers? We will come to know in our first subtopic. After that, students, we will discuss liberalization on trade barriers. In this subtopic, we will come to know about the process of liberalization, means to make trade barrier free. Okay, so let's start with the first subtopic, barriers on foreign trade. Students, foreign trade means when we have good relationship in the field of trade or business with other countries. This is called foreign trade. When trade is going on not only within the country but with foreign countries also, this is called foreign trade. But students, our government imposed few barriers there beta on foreign trade. Okay, so that trade process could go on smoothly and systematically. So why government imposed those barriers? Now we are going to discuss here. First, to have control on MNCs. Yes, beta. Government used to impose barriers over foreign trade to have a good control over MNCs, beta. Yes, multinational companies. Otherwise, what will happen? More and more companies will be established by the owners of other countries, and the people who belong to our own nation, they cannot get the opportunity for establishing their own industry or factory. Okay, and sometimes what happens, they do not get the support of the government also. So to have good control over MNCs, government used to put barriers over foreign trade so that they cannot try to have domination over the industries or factories of our own country, beta. Okay, now second, to decide the quantity of a particular finished good. Yes, beta. Government used to put barrier over foreign trade to decide this also. What quantity should be there of a particular thing which is going to be imported from foreign countries? Yes, the quantity of that particular good should also be fixed. Okay, because we know that, beta, for the process of import, when we take things from other countries, we have to pay money for that. And if we are taking too much things from other countries, it means a huge amount of money we have to pay to that country. It means we are going to affect our economy, and this is not a good sign for the progress of a particular country. So government used to put barrier over foreign trade to have a control over the quantity of a specific or particular good, beta. Okay, quantity should be fixed according to the demand of the people of the country. Okay, now next, decide the things which can be imported. Yes. Beta, not only the quantity of the thing government used to decide after putting barrier over foreign trade, but what things we have to take from other countries according to the demand of the people, this is also going to be decided by government by putting barriers. Okay? All the things cannot be imported. Okay? The traders or businessmen of other countries cannot export their things to us. Okay? We will decide that. What things we have to take from them and how much quantity we have. Excuse me. We have to take from them. So for that, we need barriers on foreign trade. Next. To give chance to our own businessmen or traders. Yes, Vita, this is also a kind of need for putting barriers on foreign trade so that our own industry owners or factory owners or traders or businessmen can get opportunity to be flourished nicely in their own country. Okay? Otherwise, what will happen if MNCs, multinational companies, will be established in numbers in our country? So our own factory owners or industry owners, which are, cannot get chance to be developed. Okay? And they can be dominated by these MNC owners. Okay? So to avoid this situation, government used to put barriers on foreign trade with them. Okay? Now, we are moving towards our next subtopic, that is liberalization on trade barriers. Okay? Now, students, under this subtopic, first we have to understand the meaning of liberalization. Liberalization means to make foreign trade free from any restriction or barriers, or less restrictions should be there. Now, why it's needed? Again, we have to discuss few points here. First, I can write here meaning of liberalization. Meaning of liberalization. Now, its meaning is to make foreign trade free from barriers, means restrictions, or less restrictions can be there. Now, why it's needed? Now, I'm going to explain you. First point. To give opportunity to MNC owners for establishing companies here. Yes, beta. Okay? Now, barriers are going to be stopped or less restrictions are there on foreign trade. Why? So that more and more MNCs, multinational companies, should be established here. Okay? Now, why? Second point will tell each and everything. To provide jobs to number of people. in our country. So what will happen, wherever those companies will be established, the local people can get chance to have job opportunities with us. Easily people can get job in these companies at different levels, as a worker, as a supervisor, as a manager, as an officer. Okay, so different work can be done by different people in these companies with us. Next, to enhance national economy. Yes, it is automatically. If people are getting job there, okay, if people have started to earn good money, so automatically the national economy will be improved. And when these MNC owners invest money here, it's also a good sign for the flourishment of our national economy beta. Okay, now next, to improve technology and communication. Yes, beta. When multinational companies are going to be established in our country, beta, it helps a lot to improve the field of technology and communication. People from foreign countries come here, work here, and become motivation and inspiration for our own people, beta. Okay, our country people get a very good chance to get knowledge from these people. So in today's session, students, we came to know about the different barriers which are needed to impose on foreign trade, and our government used to do that. And then in second subtopic, we came to know about the liberalization, means why, for means the need to make foreign trade free from these barriers or less restrictions are needed there. Okay, for enhancing national economy, for giving chance to our local people to get jobs easily in these companies, to improve the field of technology and communication, to maintain good relationship with the people of other countries. Okay, so that's all for today's session. We will meet again in our next session with the same chapter but with new subtopics. Till then, take care. Have a nice day.